Hello, we are back with Communication Toolbox episode 6, where we are connecting the dots and understanding more about communication and conflict resolution. This little episode or portion of this episode is really dedicated to Gary Smalley and his philosophy, his theories of communication from the DNA of relationships. Now, this is one of the most formative books that I read in my career, very early in my career. And I was just blown away by how Gary Smalley communicates to people. He writes in such a way that it's so readable and yet so impacting. Now, with Gary's philosophy, he really hones in on the ultimate goal of communication. The ultimate goal of communication is that everybody wins. Everybody wins. That's our goal. If I have a need, I'm hoping that you're going to catch me in my need. And if you have a need, you're hoping that I'm going to catch you as well. We really, really want to find a way to win together as frequently as possible. So just a precursor, a warning here, or an acknowledgement. We're not going to win in all of our relationships. If you expect everybody to like you, that's actually a negative belief. We're not going to have dynamite relationships with all people, and it's okay to not have relationships with some people. So if there's certain relationships that are toxic for you, then it's really healthy for you to take some time to consider what's going on inside and have boundaries, which we spoke about earlier, and sometimes have barriers. Like sometimes we just say, I'm sorry, this is too much toxic. I don't like me when I'm with you. That's a way to promote our individual winning so that we can win more in the relationships that actually carry more weight and importance in our life. Who are our people? Who is in our sphere of influence? Our children, our love, our extended family, our coworkers, our neighbors, our people in our congregation at church, at the gym, these people that really we want to do it right with. We want to have that win-win. So the philosophy of win-win is that if I win an argument and my partner fails, we both fail. And if my partner wins or they get it and I lose, then we're both losing. We get into this tit for tat, people will call it, who's the bad guy sort of scenario, where we're just like, yeah, if I could say that one thing, then I'm winning. Conflict is not a game of tennis. The metaphor might work at times, but conflict is not a game of tennis. It's not a basketball game. It's not the playoffs for some major sporting event. Our love relationship conflict is actually a signal of distress. And what we're saying is, I need you. So if I need you and you one-up me, I'm learning that my needs aren't going to be met. And if you need me and I one-up you, then you're learning that your needs aren't going to be met. So what happens is over time, we just gain more distance. It feels very, very separate, and our experience of alone is more pronounced. Our attachment fears, our attachment needs, all that stuff is just heightened. And what Gary Smalley would say is then we're living more in our core fears, these negative beliefs that are tattooed on our heart. So what do we do? Well, let's practice closure. Let's work hard to understand our own internal system and our own internal functions so that we can show up as healthy-ish as possible so that we can be with our person as best we can. And hopefully they are working in the same method. Because if one wins and the other loses, we both lose. But if one wins and the other wins, if I can need you and you can need me, if I can show up in my distress and you can meet me, and you can show up in your distress and I can meet you, even some of the time, we're win-winning. Also, if I can see your positive intention and trust that it's there, even though your behavior is so ugly. And if you can trust my positive intention and believe that it's there, even though my behavior is so ugly, that's all part of the win-win. You're gonna fight, you're not gonna get it right. You're gonna say the wrong thing, you're gonna walk away, you're gonna slam a door, you're gonna get it wrong in front of the kids, you're gonna have ugly cry, you're gonna do it all. That's distress. Distress is a part of being human. Through closure, through this mentality of win-win, that is how we start to soothe those unmet needs. Okay, you guys, there's just a little bit more of the communication toolbox, and then it's over, and then we'll see what comes next. Bye.